Okay, Kalam.
Hi students. So today we are going to do some part A laboratory. So in that laboratory we have the 6 experiments in part A, BEEE part A. We have the first experiment regarding to the verification of KVL and KCL, and second experiment in the part A and superposition theorem with analysis, and third experiment is magnetization characteristics of a DC shunt generator, and fourth experiment speed control of DC shunt motor, and fifth experiment is OC and SC test of single phase transformer, and last sixth experiment is called as a brake test of DC shunt motor. So these are the list of the experiments in the part A, BEEE part A. So now we are going to do the experiment OC SC test on single phase transformer. So in the OC SC test on single phase transformer, and now So name of the operators required for doing this experiment. OC means open circuit and SC means short circuit test. So the main purpose, aim of this experiment is to find the equivalent circuit parameters of the single phase transformer and also predetermine the efficiency and regulation at a different power factor and loads. Now, so we need to require the operators. We are going to do the experiment of OC and SC test on a single phase transformer. The first one is called as a ammeter. Now see, this is the ammeter. The range of ammeter is, and we have the two ammeters we required. The first one is called as a 0 to 1 ampere, and the next one is, so for AC test we required this ammeter. This is called as a 0 to 10 amperes. Now coming to the voltmeters, so in that voltmeter we need to require the two voltmeters, 0 to 150 volts as well as the 0 to 75. So and in what, in this voltmeter we having these both readings, 0 to 150 and 0 to 75. Now see this next one is wattmeter, which is used to measuring the power, and we need to require the LPF wattmeter and as well as the UPF wattmeter. So LPF in the sense, so the range of this one is 150 by 1 ampere. So in the UPF, and we need to require 75 volts to 10 amperes, right? So these are the voltmeters, ammeters and wattmeters were required to measuring the voltage, power and current. Now the one more is, that is called as a variac. So now here the range of the variac is 230 to 0 to 270. This is called as a auto transformer by using this to vary the voltage for different levels. And now the second one is a transformer. So now see, this is the transformer, two winding transformer. So it has the two windings, so that we can call it as a two winding transformer. So in this, so on one side of the winding we can call it as a primary, and secondary winding we can call it as a secondary. So the use of the primary, which is used to connect the supply, and secondary, and which is used to connect the load. So in the OC and SC test of a single phase transformer, so coming to here, so this is the two winding transformer. OC test means we are going to open the terminals at the secondary side of the winding. And so the primary side, and we are going to give the supply at the primary side. Then start the procedure. So in that open circuit test, first of all connect the circuit diagram as shown in figure. Now we can see the circuit diagram, connection diagram of the OC test. So here, and we need to, we have the terminals, those are called as the now see, so from the auto transformer we can take the two terminals. One terminal is called as a phase terminal, and second one is called as a neutral terminal. And we can take the phase terminal from the auto transformer, we can take the voltmeter and ammeter. So already we know that the purpose of the voltmeter is to measure the voltage, and which is used to measure the current. Now the range of the voltmeter here is 0 to 150, and here ammeter is 0 to 1 amperes. Now we can take the terminals from the phase of the auto transformer, which is connected to the positive of the two voltmeter as well as the ammeter, as like this. And we have the, so voltmeter and ammeter, right? So from the face of the
diagram, what better patana diagram le cheppi istam.
Now we can see here, so this is the face of the auto transformer, and we can take the two terminals. So one connection, one winding, which is one one wire which is connected to the voltmeter of the positive, and this is the voltmeter, and this is the positive of the connected to the positive of the voltmeter, and one more connecting wire. So now, so the second terminal, second connecting wire, which is connected to the ammeter of the positive of the ammeter. So here, this is the positive of the ammeter. Now we can take, now see, here we have the negative of the auto transformer. We can take the three terminals. So one is which is connected to the negative of the voltmeter, and the another terminal, another connection which is connected to the volt terminal of the wattmeter. So then another one is which is connected to the transformer. Transformer that is which is connected to the 150. Now we can see here, so from the ammeter of the negative of the ammeter, take one more connection, one more. So the range of this one 0 to 1, so that we can take the wire from the 1 ampere. Right. So now which is connected to the M, and we have the four terminals we have in the wattmeter. So now see here, this is the M and L, right? L and C. L, M, C, and one more is volt. So volt is refers to the and voltage, right? So here, what is the range of the voltage here? 150 volts. That's why we are going to connecting the 150 volts. Now see, the from ammeter of the negative, we can connect it to the M of the wattmeter. So which is connected to. M terminal of the wattmeter.
M and C.
And so now here, so M and C shorted by a wire, and I have take one wire, so which is connected to shorted these two terminals. Right, so this part is over. Then again from L to, so 0 volts of the transformer, second is a 2-winding transformer. This is called as a 2-winding transformer. It has a two terminals, 150, so this is called as a 150, and this is 0 volts, right? And take, so one more wire from L to, and 0 volts of the 2-winding transformer or single phase transformer. And from here, from negative of the variac auto transformer, we can take the three connecting three wires. The one from so one is which is goes to the voltmeter, and another which is goes to the voltage of the wattmeter, and another one is the 2-winding transformer. And we need to require the three wires. Then first one, which is connected to the voltmeter. Now see, this is the voltmeter, which is connected to the range of this one, 150. So that, so this is connected to the 150 voltage. Now, one more wire which is connected to the, goes to the, the wattmeter, 150. voltage there to you of the wattmeter is 150. Then the next one, so which is connected to the 115 of the two winding transformer. This is the two winding transformer. This is connected to the 115 volts of the two winding transformer. And in the case of open circuit test, and we are going to leave the open, so at the secondary of the two winding transformer, we just leave these terminals of the transformer. So that this test is called as an open circuit test. So under the open circuit test, we are going to conducting this test, and we are going to determine the no load parameters. Those are called as R0 and X0, right?
So this is same. This is same. I'm asking. Better see. Not all but one.
Procedure. So how to take the readings of the in the case of open circuit test. So here and we have the variac is there and voltmeter, ammeter and wattmeter, and this is called as a two winding transformer. So now, so by using this variac, so now see the procedure. So first of all, connect the circuit as per the circuit diagram and apply the rated voltage by varying the variac. So this is called as a variac. So by using this variac to move this variac, so up to the rated voltage which is displayed on the voltmeter, right? Now take the readings corresponding voltmeter and ammeter and as well as the wattmeter, right? And so after completion of taking these readings, and this variac will be come back to the off position, right? Now we can see the how we are going to see this one. See here how the voltmeter which is varied by varying this variac, right? Gradually I am going to varying this one. So up to the rated voltage means here the voltage rating is 150 volts.
115. அது வேறு யாருக்கு நினைச்சு அது வேறு நான் வேறு చేస్తా చూడు నేను చెప్తాను నేను వేరే చేస్తా చూడు
నౌ సో బై వేరింగ్ దిస్ వన్ సో అప్ టు ద రేటెడ్ వోల్టేజ్ now see this one, so up to the 115 and we are going to so vary up to the 115. Now see, so in this and the corresponding ammeter and wattmeter will be varied, right? So this is called as an open circuit test. So now we can note down the these readings, and I have shown the tabular column for regarding to the open circuit test. So in this and in the case of open circuit test, we have the three readings and we have to take in, that is called as a V0, I0 and W0. So V0 in the sense it is the no load condition. So under the open circuit test, the voltage, and we are going to taking this reading, and ammeter reading, I0 is nothing but current, and W0 wattmeter, what power reading, right? And so after completion of taking the readings, and again we are going to come back to the position of the variac, off position. Then we are going to switch off the main supply. Okay. Now, so this is the connection diagram. So of short circuit test. So in that short circuit test, we are having the so variac is there, and voltmeter, ammeter, as well as the wattmeter. So the range of the voltmeter in the case of short circuit test, that is 0 to 75 volts, and in the case of ammeter, that is equal to 0 to 10 amperes, and the wattmeter reading, the wattmeter range of the wattmeter is 75 to 75, and here you can see the so which is connected to the 75, and the range of the voltage current range of this one is 10 amperes, right? Now so here in the case of short circuit test, and now I am going to short this terminal at the secondary of the transformer. Short circuit means, and we are going to short these terminals by taking the one wire. So in the case of open circuit test, we just open these terminals. So under the short circuit test, and we are going to keep the rated voltage, rated current. So based on the current value, and we are going to vary this variable, right? So up to the rated voltage, and that is depends on the rating of the transformer. Here the rating of the transformer is 2 kVA, and the So the voltage rating will be 230. Here the 230. Now, so this, and here you can see, so which is connected to the 230 volts. And how to get the rated current? So from this, and we know that the rating of the transformer, that is equal to 2 kVA, and the voltage will be 230. So then we can get the value of current, I is equal to power by voltage. Then 2 kVA by 230, and we can get the 8.69. That means by varying this variable, so up to vary the rated current, that is equal to 8.69, and we can note down these voltmeter and wattmeter as well as the ammeter, right? So based on this ammeter, and we can vary this voltmeter, so vary it. And first of all, switch on this one. Right, so gradually, so varying this variable, so up to ammeter reading shows the 8.69. Right, so now we can take the readings, so voltmeter as well as the wattmeter, and so based on this meter rating, that is equal to 8.69. So this is called as a short circuit test. Now we can see the tabular column for short circuit test. In that we have the two readings, so voltage and current, wattmeter readings, right? So now you can take the reading from voltmeter and take the reading from the ammeter, and you can take the reading from the wattmeter. So this is about the short circuit test. Then again, after completion of this one, taking these readings and to come back to the off position and to switch off the main supply. Thank you. Okay. So after conducting this OC and AC test of a single phase transformer, whatever the values we are getting, so OC test as well as the short circuit test, these values are substitute these under the OC test, and we can get the R0 and X0. These are the no load parameters, R0 and X0. And in the case of short circuit test, right, and we are going to note down the, already we know that under the short circuit test, voltage value, current, as well as the wattmeter readings, and substitute these values, and we can find the value of the efficiency as well as the regulation, right? So now, so these are the different power factors. I think about different load conditions, different power factors. So what is the lagging power factor and what about the leading power factor? Here we having the formulas for finding the regulation as well as the formula for finding the efficiency also. Now see this one. So and we are going to find the efficiency for different load conditions. For different load condition means at full load condition, right? And 3/4 load full condition, 3/4 full load, and 1/4 full load condition, and sorry, 1/4 full load. Then we are going to find the total losses, and then so once after getting the value of total losses and substitute this one, output plus total losses, and finally the efficiency, which is equal to, this is the formula for finding the efficiency, which is equal to output power by input power into 100, and we can get the efficiency. Now see, this is the input power which we are getting from the, once after knowing the value of output and the losses we are getting from these equations only, and once after getting the these losses and substitute this, adding this output power to the losses, then we can get the input power. Then finally we are going to calculating the efficiency, right? So now see, this is expected graphs of, and which is the first one is the efficiency versus the output power. So already, so from this tabular column already we know the values of the, what is the output power. Take the output power on the y-axis and efficiency on the y-axis, and if you are going to draw this curve, and we can get like this, and this is the regulation curve, and here we are having the lagging power factor and the leading power factor, and whatever the after completion of this calculation for finding the regulation, and take the lagging power factors on this side and leading power factor on the negative side of the x-axis, and regulation values, and we can get the negative values of the leading power factor, regulation values, and positive regulation at the lagging power factor, right? So based on that, those readings, we can draw this regulation versus power factor curve, right? Then finally, we are going to, finally, so after completion of this one, so finally, we are going to write this result, like what we are going to done from this experiment.